All right. Let's try that again, shall we? Can you hear me? I guess I had the Bluetooth connected, like always, in my car. No sound, no sound, no audio. Hey, Doug, no sound, can't hear you. Keep trying, I'm talking right now. I turned the Bluetooth off. So, better, better, yes, yay. We can hear you now, woo! Okay, there we go. Like I was saying, today was a very fun-filled day. We, man, essentially, let me tell you guys what was going on here. Let me tell you, let me fill you in. I'm kind of, what do you call it? Little wiry, you know, definitely had a good day today. We are in Lakeland, Florida, and we was here searching for a lady named Margaret Smith. She went missing 9 months ago in her car. And, ooh, Margo, thank you. Becoming a member. But she went missing in her Kia Soul. Nobody knows where she went. There's lots of details to this case. But the videos that will be coming out in a couple weeks are going to explain everything. So I don't want to bore you guys with all the details of the case. But long story short, today, which was the second day we was looking for her, she was found. Jared actually discovered her in a, like, one of those little retention ponds that you see in the back of neighborhoods, like pretty much to control the floodwaters. Never in a million years would you have expected there to be a car in this body of water, but sure enough, surprise, surprise, there she was. And sorry, let me look around real quick. I'm looking for something. This could be an issue. I don't know. Oh, never mind. They're twist tops. Wow. That was pretty. Anyway. It was like a last ditch effort. Me and Adam and Britton, we was at a different pond scanning some sonar. And we got the text message from Jared. And the text message said, we found her. And so I start screaming at the guys. I'm like, pack up, pack up. We got to get over there. Within 10 minutes, we was on scene. And no cops were there yet. The cops were just on their way. And they, it's the craziest thing. Because, like, if you've seen this body of water, it was 6 feet deep. The car was literally 18 inches under the water. It's amazing that nobody saw this car there for like 9 months. It was nuts, right? But sure enough, tow truck came in, all the cops came, and they kind of corralled us. Bigger city, so the cops, you know, they did their job, but they wouldn't really let us get around or get too close. So we got to watch from a distance, but the tow truck pulled this Kia out of the water, and there was remains in the car. And we don't speculate, so essentially what we do is we know that there are remains in the car. We know the car belonged to Margaret, and that's all we know. So officially, human remains were found in the vehicle, but 100% confirmation will be done when they get the remains back to the lab, run the test, DNA, dental records, forensics, whatever they do really to get the answers they're looking for, you know what I mean? But we find this a huge success, you know, and meeting up with Jared and getting to help him solve some more cold cases and learning more stuff so we can solve cases ourselves. It's truly an amazing opportunity, you know. And like me and Jared, we started this YouTube game kind of at the same time. And he is like 1.7 million subs, you know. I got a good following. Britton, Adam, we've all created something really amazing. And now we're bringing all of this, all these channels together to create like a super channel, you know, that we go out hunting for missing persons and cold cases. And it's just pretty crazy. But now you guys know what I know. I wanted to catch you guys up. I know a video didn't drop today, but I wanted to go live and tell you guys exactly what's going on. And, you know, we're still going to be in Florida for a few more days. We got a few more locations to hit. And then we're gonna head back up, take a couple days of relaxation, and then get right back at it again. It's pretty fun. Let's go through some of the comments real quick to see if anybody has any questions. I'm seeing lots of, seems these guys, ooh, you know what? This is a comment that I will address right now. Seems these guys only find Caucasian people. Wrong. I do believe, not this person obviously today, but the last person that Jared found was not Caucasian. She's African American. So it's quite insulting to think that we're only looking for white folk when we're just looking for human beings. Doesn't matter what kind of color, race, gender they are. We just want to find the missing loved ones and get them home to their family. So shame on you for saying that. Moving on. Let's see, what else we got in the comments real quick. Does that mean you all share the reward money, or does Jared still take most? Another mean comment. If there was even a reward, it would be split equal ways. Jared is not selfish and pockets it himself. I don't care what you guys heard. Moving on from that comment. Did you happen to catch a gator? No, but Doug did dive on some vehicles and found... he actually swam up on a little gator. Just a little fella. Nothing too crazy. What else we got going on in here? Let's scroll down to the bottom. Catch up with everything. Thank you for going live. Exploring with Nug. How you doing? That's such a low blow comment. Right? Some people don't understand that whole mouth typing insults. It's pretty crazy. But in a nutshell, let's see. Question, how many people have all of you found in total? I think today was Jared's 19th missing person. I personally found three. You know, and all of us have been, well, I don't know. I found two by myself. Britton has helped me with one. And so I guess add those up, and that's what we're looking at. I know Jacob, Chaos Divers, he's found a handful himself. I'm not too sure of the numbers, but if we just found one, that's one more person that gets, you know, that the family gets answers. How expensive is sonar equipment? I mean, it depends on what you want. I mean, you can go tens of thousands of dollars if you really gotta go nuts with it. A good solid set, you're looking at a few grand. It's gonna be an investment, but it is well worth it if you really want to get into this stuff, or if you're big on fishing, you know, that's because ultimately that's what they're for. Come on down to Kansas and see our giant catfish, the weight of a grown man, mostly seen in the Kansas River. I've seen some pretty big old catfish. I don't know, they ain't that big, but I'm sure they're around here somewhere. Let's see here. Thanks for the update. I will follow you. Any idea on how the car entered the pond? No idea. It was a straight road. The neighborhood wasn't even built when she drove through there. So it was just a construction site with a straight road. And at the end of it was a pond. We're kind of leaning towards maybe a medical situation, accidental, not suicide or foul play, but we don't know any answers for sure. So this is just kind of theorizing what we think happened. Just scanning through the comments really quick. Nug, did you serve in the military? I did 4 years in the Navy, 2001 to 2005. I got to be part of the aftermath of 9/11. Went overseas, you know, did my part, survived, made it out. I was on a carrier, so it wasn't near as dangerous as people who had boots on the ground, but y'all get it. Let's see here. So she could have a concussion from the other accident that she's in. It's possible. We looked at the car. You could see it on the thumbnail in this picture, and I posted some pictures on Facebook. The front end of this car, obviously the bumper's ripped off, but I think it just got ripped off and they pulled it out of the pond. But the passenger fender had a little bit of damage to it, which, you know, fender bender, so I guess that kind of makes sense. But it wasn't a serious accident. It looked like a bump. But even still, you know, that could have contributed to the fallout of how she ended up in that pond. I mean, nobody really knows. Thank you for your service. Thank you. Hi from Oklahoma. Tons of cars in St. John's River. Let's see. I pray every day for you to find Virginia Collier. You can do it. We're looking. We went back again with Jared. We looked another day. We found... well, that day we didn't find anything, but we've been finding cars and trucks in that river, and which is not her. So I think eventually we're going to find her. We just got to narrow it down. How does one become a member? I believe if you just go to my page, you know, the Exploring with Nugs YouTube page, you know, there's the button there that says subscribe, and then there's also a button that says join. You can press the join button and you can pick the membership. If you don't feel like being a member, you can always do one-time donations through PayPal. There's a link in the description below, or you can anything you really think if you want to do. There's Amazon wish list, there's Venmo, Cash App, all that stuff. If you feel like you want to donate, by all means, go for it. If not, just keep on watching these videos because that helps me grow. And in turn, I get to do this stuff, making videos more often. Depths of History is going live. Surprise, surprise. Just curious, why the name Nug? It started at work. My friends found out that I was metal detecting on YouTube, and it was a Nug, Nugget, Gold Nugget, stuff like that. I did not steal it from Nugget Noggin. I don't care what he thinks. I wish he would, I hope he doesn't think that. I know we've dove before and stuff, but you know, everyone still says, why'd you steal Nugget Noggin's name? I didn't, but it is a cool name. So, I mean, he should be flattered. I think I seen something in here. Rosetta Roper 499 super chat. Thank you so much. Any and all money donations obviously goes right back into the channel. You should see the truck that I drive when I'm not in my scuba van. My father actually gave it to me. It's a beast. It's a big old Ford older model, and you know, and it does the job. I'm not taking all my cool donations and money and stuff and buying brand new things. Neither is Jared, neither is Britton, Adam. We all spend all the money we make, on the channel to get better equipment so we can do this, do what we do more, you know, better, I guess you could say. Like, I got my eye on a new scuba ride, a bigger one, because I'm quickly running out of money, and maybe some more features in it, you know, like cruise control, because the one I got right now is a base model, and it's just, it is what it is. But looks like we got $10 super chat from Helen, Helen Daly. Thank you for all your help in finding these people that have been missing. Don Reed dropping $10. Thank you so much. Whoops, there we go. So to recap, Margaret Smith was found today. She, you know, sadly she was found, but she was found to have perished, possibly. Not 100% confirmed because we don't know, you know, obviously we don't know whose remains are in the car, but it is what it is. We are still in Lakeland. We're probably going to pack up and leave in the morning after breakfast. And we're going to head to our next location. Wesley Shoup, drop me $20, get something to eat. I will. Not tonight. We already just ate. Thanks, Jared. He bought us all a congratulatory dinner. So once again, for everybody that thinks Jared is a hater and is selfish, he's not. He's a good guy. You know, obviously drama, rumors, all that stuff that went down back in the past. It's all crap. So yeah, you know, like we're all good people doing good things out here, and Jared's one of them. So by all means, if you're gonna hate on him, do it somewhere else, because this is a the people that follow me know, you know, the kind of person that Jared is, I hope. And if you don't, now you do. When is the last day of the tour? I want to say February 9th, I think, is when it's officially done for now. And we're going to be heading up, me and Britton and Adam, maybe those guys too. We want to hit some springs up on the way back and do some videos. I've never dove in the springs yet, so I just want to play around, you know, maybe do a little bit of scuba diving in the springs. Keep on diving. You've done so much for many. It's just neat. Okay, well, gonna wrap it up now. I just want to give you guys a heads up. Rusty, thank you so much for the $5. Woo! Laura coming in with the $50 Canadian. I think that's what that means. Thank you guys so much for these donations. And if you're watching this video in the replay and you're feeling the need to donate, PayPal link is in the description below. And by all means, if money's tight, which we all know how money can be really tight, don't even worry about donating. It's not even a big deal. But if you do want to help, you can find the links, you know, and all the money that I make, all the toys, you know, that I get, go right into the channel so we can keep doing this. So anyway, I'm glad you guys joined me on this quick little live stream, and keep watching, subscribe, because we're just gonna keep on doing this. Dana with the $20, thank you so much, man. I think I should stay on here. Everybody wanted to give me some cash. I don't mind. Look at that, $14.99 Australian down under diving. I think it's Down Under Dan Diving. That's what, yeah. That's cool. I like that guy. He's a good guy. Praying you find many more. We will. We're going to keep looking. We're going to have a lot more fun here in Florida. Keep up the good work. Swamp Water with Freshwater Spring. Or the Freshwater Spring coming up. Oh, yeah. But anyway, thank you guys so much. I'm going to get out of here. Until we meet again, my name is Jeremy. I will see you guys on the next video. Maybe.